Frustration over finding a place to get the COVID vaccine, one of the best places may soon also be one of the most familiar. Here's Stephanie Gosk.
This CVS pharmacy on Long Island, New York, gives out the flu shot every year, but that is not what's happening here. Gene, how did it go?
Excellent. Very smooth. Walked in early. Got taken early.
This is the COVID vaccine.
There's dry ice in there that keeps the vaccine at ultra-cold temperatures.
One of two CVS locations kicking off what will be a nationwide effort.
We actually administered about 20 million flu vaccinations last year, so our pharmacists have been doing this for a while.
Have you had to hire more people to handle the vaccinations?
Absolutely. This is a dedicated clinic. It has its own staffing associated.
This fall, Operation Warp Speed announced it was partnering with nearly 20 pharmacy chains across the country. The pilot program just getting off the ground.
Do you think some comfort in coming to a place that's familiar?
Very much so.
Oh, sure.
Much more calming than going into, like a hospital.
It's something you're used to doing, and it's convenient, and it works.
But experts warn this is not nearly as simple as just giving a flu shot.
Doing a COVID vaccination in the middle of a pandemic, that's going to be very challenging. They're going to have to figure out how to bring people to the pharmacy, but keep them safe.
CVS and Walgreens have already been vaccinating at long-term care facilities in 49 states. They say they are on target to get all first doses at skilled nursing centers done by next week. But some states say it's been way too slow.
They're facing a lot of challenges. I think we have to stay the course. The efforts with the pharmacies are starting to pick up now. We're seeing good results.
The next phase, those in-store vaccinations.
People are dealing with crashed websites, phone lines that ring busy. They're unable to make appointments. How can Walgreens ensure that that doesn't happen?
It's important to know that we already have this infrastructure in place. We have a technology platform that allows for people to schedule appointments.
Registration will happen right on the main websites. Both visits can be scheduled at once. Before coming to CVS, the wine gardens heard complaints about the state-run system, from scheduling to supply.
I was skeptical that it would actually happen, and I'm very, very happy to report that everything went better than we expected.
In their words, easy, comfortable, and fast. Stephanie Gosk, NBC News, Long Island.
And up next for us tonight, who wants to be a billionaire? All right, we're back now with Lotto Fever. Tonight's Mega Millions jackpot, up to a massive $1 billion, comes after a single winning ticket for this week's $731 million Powerball drawing was sold in Maryland. So far, that winner remains a mystery. After a 55-year career at NBC News, Tom Brokaw announced his retirement today. Tom anchored this broadcast for more than two decades and was co-anchor of the Today Show before that. He was also White House correspondent covering the Nixon presidency and Watergate, then Gerald Ford's presidency. Tom started at NBC in Los Angeles back in 1966. Over the years, he brought us many of the biggest stories in this country and overseas, including the fall of the Berlin Wall.
Live from the Berlin Wall on the most historic night in this wall's history. What you see behind me is a celebration of this new policy announced today by the East German government.
An incredible moment. In recent years, Tom was a special correspondent for NBC News. I want to personally thank Tom for his counsel and friendship. All of us here wish Tom and Meredith and their family our very best wishes. That's nightly news for this Friday. Thank you for watching, everyone. I'm Lester Holt. Please Please take care of yourself and each other.
In an attempt to overturn the election results. Will that be part of his upcoming impeachment trial? Turn violent. 10,000 across Russia march against the extreme crowd of security forces and the protest leader arrested while doing a TV interview. New shutdowns in China as cases rise, and our reporter goes back to Wuhan 1 year after the world's first mass lockdown there. Life now back to normal. Mystery in one city. Who won last night's $1 billion jackpot?
Not bad for a Friday. This is NBC Nightly News with Jose Diaz-Balart.
Good evening. It is day four of the new Biden administration, and the challenges grew even larger today. We not only hit 25 million COVID cases in the U.S., but New York's governor is now saying they ran out of first doses of the vaccine, with more trickling in. This, as the United Kingdom announces, the new strain that started there isn't just more contagious, it may also be more deadly. And we're learning more about how former President Trump's impeachment trial will play out, which could slow the progress of Joe Biden's new agenda. We have it all covered for you tonight, beginning with Sam Brock in Florida.
Calling the country's fight against COVID a war, New York Governor Andrew Cuomo made a chilling revelation Saturday.
Exhausted all the vaccines that we have received to date, week 1 to 5. We are now starting to receive week 6 allocations, which trickle in during the week.
With supply tapped, some vaccination sites stopped giving doses.
This is really horrible.
This woman clearly frustrated after securing an appointment in Brooklyn, only to be turned away.
There was like no signage on the street. We are, or we're canceled.
And the struggle for doses is hardly specific to a region. From Florida.
Every week we get our allocations, and it's half of the week before.
To California.
Half is not enough. What we have coming is not enough.
Maryland and beyond.
There is incredible demand out there. There is very limited supply.
A national crisis of available vaccine, culminating for some families like Missy Steiner's dead ends and tears.
It's breaking my heart. My parents just want to get the vaccine, and every morning my mom, you know, we text and we are calling, and she's crying.
President Biden just rolled out an aggressive plan to boost supply and distribution as the CDC grants more wiggle room between shots of the two-dose vaccines. Writing, the second dose should be administered as close to the recommended interval as possible, but if that's not feasible, vaccines may be scheduled for administration up to 6 weeks after the first dose.
Is there anything in science to tell us that if you went from 3 or 4 weeks to 6 weeks between doses, it would be any less effective?
Your immune system, primed by the first dose, should respond very well even after 6 weeks, but that's not something we're encouraging.
We reached out to both Pfizer and Moderna for comments, but our request was either declined or unanswered.
Sam joins us now from Hard Rock Stadium, a mass vaccination site. Sam, Florida was the first to vaccinate the general public. Will they have second doses for everyone?
So Florida's Governor Jose says there's a federal allotment of second doses to match the first for now. That is also true in New York, but the bigger issue here might be unused capacity. Where I'm standing at Hard Rock Stadium, they should be vaccinating 3,000 people a day. Right now, Jose, it is a third of that because of supply issues. Jose?
Sam Brock in Miami Gardens, thank you. President Biden had a new warning today about just how severe the pandemic may get. It comes as we learn new details about former President Trump's attempts to overturn the election results. It's information that may factor into his upcoming impeachment trial. Kelly O'Donnell reports from the White House.
A working first Saturday as Vice President Harris arrived at the White House today. And President Biden addressed the U.S. Conference of Mayors on video with a dire assessment of the pandemic fallout.
The brutal truth is that things are going to get worse the next several months before they get better.
Urging more personal responsibility now.
Masks, not vaccinations, are the single best defense that we have against COVID-19.
Soon, the Biden agenda will collide with a Trump impeachment trial. Monday, Speaker Pelosi will send the single article, Incitement of Insurrection, to the Senate. But the action then hits pause for 2 weeks.
Need a full and fair process where the former president can mount a defense.
Democrats willing to wait, allowing more Senate time for Biden priorities, including cabinet confirmations. The Trump trial to begin February 9th.
Healing and unity will only come if there is truth and accountability.
Today, Leader Schumer called for a new investigation of a separate Trump aftershock. The New York Times was first to report, and NBC News confirmed, Mr. Trump engaged in a plan to upend the Justice Department to overturn the election. A DOJ official says Mr. Trump considered firing Acting Attorney General Jeffrey Rosen, who refused to pressure Georgia to change its results, then replacing him with government lawyer Jeffrey Clark, more sympathetic to Mr. Trump's wishes. But when other justice officials threatened a mass resignation, aides said that persuaded President Trump to stand down. Asked to respond, a Trump advisor tells NBC News President Trump argued for investigating the broader rampant election fraud, adding any assertion to the contrary is false.
And Kelly joins us now. Kelly, President Biden spoke with a close U.S. ally who was particularly friendly with President Trump.
Yes, Britain's Prime Minister Boris Johnson went public first, even posting photos of himself on the call with President Biden. The Times looking quite animated. The White House has not described this call publicly yet. Johnson says they discussed COVID, climate change, and the desire to get together in person when that becomes possible. Jose?
Kelly O'Donnell at the White House, thank you. President Biden is putting strict new travel rules in place to combat COVID as health officials warn of an alarming new strain that's spreading overseas. Megan Fitzgerald reports.
Tonight, new warnings from health officials about contagious variant strains of the virus that may also be more deadly.
The variant that was first identified in London and the southeast may be associated with a higher degree of mortality.
And while Dr. Anthony Fauci says he believes the vaccine will still be effective.
It looks like the UK strain, that even though there might be a slight, if any, diminution in the ability of the vaccine to contain and block this virus, it's not going to have a significant impact on our vaccine program.
But even with the vaccine, the CDC warns the UK variant could be dominant in the country by March. And while the South African and Brazilian strains haven't been detected here yet, health officials are concerned that we could see a danger.
with anti-Putin demonstrators. Tonight, the Biden administration is condemning the violence. Sarah Harman has late details.
Tonight, stunning scenes across Russia. Tens of thousands taking to the streets in a massive show of support for Russia's jailed opposition leader, Alexei Navalny, President Putin's most vocal critic. His lawyer cordoned off by riot police while addressing the media. Scuffles breaking out in some places, with protesters beaten and bloody. Demonstrators lobbing snowballs at police. More than 2,600 people were arrested, including Navalny's wife, Yulia, who was later released. Navalny himself remains behind bars after his dramatic airport arrest Sunday, returning home to handcuffs after months in Germany recovering from nerve agent poisoning that nearly killed him.
Has something just changed in Russia?
What we see now is a real change. We're seeing a burst of new feeling.
Tonight, Navalny faces an uncertain future. The Biden administration has called for the immediate release of him and the protesters. Sarah Harman, NBC News.
Up next, back to Wuhan, 1 year after the world's first COVID lockdown. What is it like now? It was 1 year ago today that a word entered daily conversation: lockdown. China was the original epicenter of COVID-19 and the site of the first and perhaps most severe lockdown in the world. Our reporter Janice MacIntyre fled the city. Tonight, she goes back.
Tonight, with fresh outbreaks and new fears, some Chinese cities are locking down. A massive quarantine center was built in days. In Beijing, huge lines for mass testing and everywhere digital surveillance.
I need to scan to prove to the driver that I'm healthy, and that information also goes for contact tracing.
The worry, new COVID strains ahead of the Lunar New Year. The government now urging, even paying people to not travel. It comes as the virus had largely faded, a year after the world's first lockdown in Wuhan. Back then, we scrambled to leave as the city fell silent. We've since returned to where life appears normal, with morning swims and packed nightclubs. The virus relegated to China's version of history in a huge museum paying tribute to health workers and the country's leader, Xi Jinping. Yet in the shadows, there's also grief. Zhang Hai's father died of COVID before it had a name. He's trying to sue local officials. If I don't speak out, nothing will change, he says. A World Health Organization team is in Wuhan to explore the origin of the virus.
There's been a lot of blame being put around about this pandemic. It originated somewhere.
The first cluster of cases traced to a market.
It still isn't clear whether the Huanan market was the source of the virus, though outside experts believe it was a starting point for the outbreak.
Where Chinese officials took samples over a year ago.
Why has the data not been shared?
No, they didn't isolate the virus. That's the issue.
What about live animal samples?
It doesn't tell you anything if they only test positive. I do not suspect it's coming from what we originally thought.
China's government is crafting its own narrative, a patriotic film premiering today that presents the city where the virus first emerged as the one that survived to defeat it. Janice MacIntyre, NBC News, Wuhan.
Well, you know the old saying, feels like $1 million for one lucky jackpot winner. Today, they're feeling like $1 billion. After weeks of no jackpot winners at all, last night, somebody finally hit it really big in the Mega Millions drawing. Kathy Park is on the case.
Yeah. Let's see if I can make you a billionaire tonight.
These six numbers on one Mega Millions ticket made someone $1 billion richer overnight. The mystery winner bought the ticket at this Novi, Michigan Kroger, just outside Detroit.
I went there,
numbers are printed at the Coney Market in Lona Koenig, one of two convenience stores in town.
That's such a huge amount of money, who knows what. They might just disappear.
It is a possibility in Maryland, where you can remain anonymous. But what about Michigan?
Does this winner have to come forward?
So they will have to come forward and reveal themselves. I think after that, they could go hide away on an island if they wanted to, or buy one, maybe.
A lucky week of winners. And for the rest of us, well, there's always next time. Kathy Park, NBC News.
I'm Jose Diaz-Balart. Thank you for the privilege of your time. Good night.
Hey, NBC News viewers. Thanks for checking out our YouTube channel. Subscribe by clicking on that button down here.
First local COVID-19 case in months. A 56-year-old woman returned from an overseas trip late last month and tested positive for the coronavirus days after a two-week mandatory quarantine at the border. Under quarantine, she had tested negative twice. A top New Zealand health official said it's possible her case is a variant found in the UK or elsewhere.
We are working on the assumption that this is a positive case and that it is a more transmissible variant, either one of the one identified first in South Africa or the UK or potentially Brazil or another more transmissible variant.
Health officials added it's unknown if the woman caught the disease abroad or locally. New Zealand last reported a community case in mid-November, according to the Health Ministry Online. The island nation of 5 million people has virtually eliminated COVID-19 within its borders, with less than 2,000 cases since the global health crisis began, helped by a strict lockdown and its geographical isolation. But with COVID-19 raging globally, more positive cases are returning to New Zealand, raising concern of a possible community outbreak of a more transmissible variant. Pressure has been mounting on Prime Minister Jacinda Ardern's government to vaccinate the population, but she has said a mass rollout won't begin until the second half of this year.
And up next on Asia Now, one of the world's most wanted fugitives behind a syndicate dominating the Asia-Pacific drug trade has been arrested. Plus, non-governmental organizations in Gaza wrap up mechanical ventilation has brought 4,000 up for the first time ever. That figure was 1,000 less during its first week in April.
Shows
and it comes
as more
another
deadly.
1,348 deaths and 33,000+ new infections were reported on Saturday. The UK is presently prioritizing the first dose in its vaccination drive, and the second shot will only come 12 weeks after the first. Fearing a months-long wait could reduce the efficacy of the vaccine, senior doctors are calling for the duration to be shortened.
I mean, all those other countries are also suffering similar pressures of lack of vaccine, of increasing numbers of cases, hospitalization, but their scientists have adopted a position to try and keep to the manufacturer's guidance, but also the WHO's own proposal of a maximum of 42 days interval. So that's why we put forward this letter and why we would like to have dialogue with the Chief Medical Officer with this issue.
Currently, at least 5 million Britons have been given a vaccine dose. A record 478,000 plus received their shot in the last 24 hours. Pandemic has hit Gaza hard. The Strip's 2 million residents are relying on handouts from foreign aid more than ever before, amid growing poverty and unemployment. Many non-governmental organizations are stepping up their efforts with local charities on humanitarian relief, healthcare, and education projects. Rami Al-Gharawi reports from Gaza.
This aid convoy is a welcome sight in Gaza. The nine trucks are carrying much-needed medical equipment, clothing and food that has been donated by Chinese traders. Such humanitarian missions have been delivering aid from China to Gaza's most desperate for the past 3 years. The Al-Wiam Relief Society, a local NGO that has been in operation for 15 years, is in charge of receiving and distributing the aid.
في جمهورية الصين الشعبية تحت عنوان حملة إعادة البسمة لفقراء قطاع غزة. هذه المساعدات جمعناها من التجار في مدينة كوانزو في الصين.
For many years, local and charity. Service have worked closely with a number of Asian NGOs to provide much needed assistance to the strip, including those from Malaysia. Alhamdulillah, we became a bridge for the other organizations in Malaysia to help the people of Gaza. And as of now, we have about 20 other NGOs or
It's like a cult thing. You can be talking to people in the morning and you can be in your little shack somewhere, right? Like a cult thing. Pretty trippy.
Get off our property thing.
Yeah.
Stop hunting and poaching the animals.
People be tripping. Like, get
out.
Get out.
Mm-hmm. The signs that you're on camera. And all other kind of sensors. There is no hiding your identity. Noise. Getting 4 to 6 amps. No direct sunlight. About to push past 2 kilowatts. Barely any sunlight over there. But that's good for right now because we need step down modules because this guy's producing too much power. For this, so I'll just start getting direct sunlight on there and start jumping from 13 volts up to working voltage, is supposed to be 48 volts, but it shoots all the way to 76 and stuff. That's interesting. I get some step down modules to keep from frying the batteries. Boost amp. Morning, beautiful day. Make energy. Doing shit on fucking forests and other things and showing that it can be changed and other shit like that. Where the fuck is going on? Where's the leashes of the Sai Baba motherfuckers? Because there's like several millions of them people fucking striking this shit. I give you. Just recognized around the world. Shit, Malaysia and all them places like that, honey, we're fucking, we're watching the stuff where they got everybody outside doing Tai Chi and shit. Where's the data to show the people not doing Tai Chi to the people out doing Tai Chi together? Socially distancing. Getting infected to not getting infected. You understand what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. You understand? No, do you understand what I'm saying? Because statistically, when you look at who was dying more prevalent from the fucking original strain, was people that were lethargic.
Yeah.
If you wish to say in a fucked up manner of you're lazy, but not in the sense of you're lazy, because myself, I was lethargic. Even though I got out and did things, my work caused me to be sedentary the way that I was unless I go out and exercise myself in a manner. It makes me susceptible underneath being in a sense for myself, lethargic in the sense of I'm not running, I'm not getting that pace up. If you understand what I'm saying.
Yeah.
I was in a lethargic, rudimentary, sluggish, I
itinerary I had where it was like, couch potato. I do this, I do that. But not watching TV, it's just sitting there like this. Just sitting down, but not getting exercise. Now I'm getting exercise and so forth, and getting the aspiration and opening the vascular and beryllium and so forth of my lungs. Those people that have not done such are aspirating from it, dying. Otherwise, the cardiovascular, because you have that stress from the small veins and other things like that, and the thrombosis and the D-dimer and all that, and the cytokines work. If you have an issue where you're not, you know, your diaphragm is weak, then it hits you. The solar post issue, your heart problem. And that ACE2 receptor, vitamin D, eating all the right proper foods, the selenium and other things, makes where your body doesn't go for what that thing has as a piece of candy saying, hey, come here. Now this new stuff, that's why you see the athletic people, everybody get out, and people are like, man, fuck you, I'm in a gym, I'm the healthiest, you know?
Yeah. Be my healthiest.
And now you see everybody across the board getting smacked, and it's like, come on, man, if you don't see a difference in the weight press or the person with old people, and then people fucking my age, and now you got the young kids and teenagers and little kids fucking getting smacked by it, come on, man, wake up. Don't open the schools. Shut this shit down. But like 100 years ago, where the fuck was radionics practitioners and all this stuff, dude? Because by that time, he had 20 years of Albert Abrams flying around the world. He was on the third or fourth fucking procurement of his radionics device.
Mm-hmm.
You understand what I'm saying? No, you understand what I'm saying? You had it spread around the world. You had a worldwide nude, 4 worldwide nude articles, 7 groups. You had almost all of the head Catholic, non-Catholic fucking churches using this shit.
See, no, seriously. Beyond, before that, just dynasties
Seventh-day
and priests.
Seventh-day Adventists and so forth, you can read in their stuff where they use it. Alcohol, that's all I'm saying. If you look in the studies of Alcoholics Anonymous, they were using radioactive cure people along with LSD and shit. That's what I did. That was my sponsor. Phil fucking tripped me out. I was like, what? That one my head up. You understand? What the fuck happened was going on 100 years ago in the Spanish flu time? With all those people, William Rife, all the people. What happened? What was going on?
Well, they destroyed all the...
How did they...
They destroyed all of his shit.
I understand that, but I'm saying at the time that the man was alive, happened when the Spanish flu happened and all that shit. How did his works not be seen? I mean, I know media's not the same as such, but he still had, again, at that time, worldwide groups of people move around. Madame McCalsey was still fucking doing her shit. You understand what I'm saying? You get what I'm saying? How did fucking, here, stand in line and let's get a fucking shot in your arm, fucking become a forefront.
When NASA and every other military intelligence department or, you know, commission part of the state
started.
Is using this.
Yes, and started.
And lives by it.
And started in this realm.
Ezekiel, the PDF that I was reading yesterday is talking about the head of the, in 1995, the doctor, the head doctor, you know, of the Stanford University. It's like all people that do this, you know, and it's an Indian dude in 1995, Nobel Prize winner, you know, things like that. He was born in India, ended up here in Stanford, being the head of the university, part of psychology and psychophysics and whatnot. And it's like, it's their truth, they just don't want to share it. Is it for some reason they don't believe that people are ready for it? For some reason they don't believe that it's a way, it's their way, they're doing it, that's their whole reality, and But it's behind the scenes. It's like, here, we're going to show you these studies about whatever fucking cancer, little progress we have done. And in behind the scenes, we're really fucking working on all this.
And show you the truth of modality is, because it's been accepted in the paradigm that Apple been involved in the theory of gravity, Newton's thing, and E equals MC squared, that's all been blown away by these and the study of such.
Why not add up on that knowledge and stand on that plateau instead of like, we're left back here, or the populace, the masses is left back here with those like equations that are for old paradigms, and they're living by the new, or by the constants that have been just learned new or observed, and it's just, why not have everybody on the same page? If you understand by those principles that we are one consciousness, you would need all parts to part, wouldn't you? Because why would I, the reason why I help people, part of it is that they're part of me and I benefit from that too, right? Or part of that one. So why wouldn't they want to, unless they're not consuming it as such and they're just...
Because it all depends on what the conceptualization is in the person's mind.
Yeah. Is seen as abilities of tapping into the unseen or dark or whatnot, but not seen as oneness, maybe. I understand what you're saying.
It's just like the question I always pose to you. How do people heal thousands of people? But every historical radionics practitioner, radiesthesia person, psychonaut, psychotronic, murdered by their own device. Or Stomperly, I won't put it.
Cure them.
Yes.
They had at the fingertips of their hands equipment that could easily cure them.
And they die from such heart strokes, so forth.
Well, you see, what's his name? Jeff Harvey. He's having, man had like an environment where, despite him being a targeted individual, like, but before that, in his body, he had radiation or whatnot, of occupational disease and things, and the experiments and things that military that he's gone through and whatnot, and being part of, and then at the late, I believe he was targeting individuals, so it's really hard. It was hard for him to heal, but he explains, like in that audio I was hearing last year, one time I used to at the shop, that when I was saying like, I didn't know that the body secretes water, you know, like creates water at that level. And I was hearing an audio of him, and he talks how he has himself in an AC-5000 at all times, balancing himself, you know. And still, the man died, you know? I mean, I understand at some point we're all going to die, but it's like you are balancing yourself at a level that, at a blueprint level. How is it that you're not able to rewrite it, overcome at a chromosome level where this is not manifesting like this in the physical form anymore? What is in that expression is not showing? Why the work that you're doing is not showing in that expression?
That's why it was murdered and what they did.
Right. So that when you ask things like that, my only thing is the equipment is doing its job. The person is doing what they're meant to be doing.
No,
they're being attacked.
How do you get re out of balance? Because the people that I work with don't get re out of balance.
Yeah.
Those chirality points are wrong. Once you're gone, the person don't complain about that issue no more or nothing like that. It doesn't connect.
That's
why I asked, what's the difference between my mouth and
my tooth pain, everything back, my knee pain, everything back.
There's a difference. I understand what you're saying, but maybe you understand what I'm saying.
Si.
How is that made to where you come back? From seeing and feeling the ways that thing worked, you know, you help me guide myself to change where my shit's more permanent, but still I ask, that's why I always ask. I was just like, such. All the people doing that used to go to the psychic fair, you know what I'm saying? Like, what's going on in the community? You know what I'm saying? What's going on in the community? Because those who actually know what's going on and can do something, man, motherfucker can't even put the word given or fucking nothing like that. Can't even post some damn pictures. Showing some shit. Like, nope. You got the narrative on that. You gotta get a vaccine. Okay. Show me how the vaccine works, man. Because the vaccine ain't doing the goddamn thing. And you idiots are on that herd of immunity going, we gotta get 200 million people, and then we'll be alright. And all you gotta do is just modify the spike on this fucking shit where it's gonna be more virulent. Because it's gonna go, okay, I gotta adapt to get you. How do I do that? You keep messing with the spike. You're gonna adapt the spike more where fucking everybody's gonna have the escape mutation and it's just gonna be more violent. You'll see the expression from the first variation that came out where you get the system failure and the cytokine D-dimer issue and so forth that goes throughout the body. Shit go through other muscular tissues to try to hide from the immune system to evade it, since different immune responses and so forth happen in different tissues in different ways. You're just gonna get that fucked up cascade effect through people. The leukocytes and shit that shouldn't be there don't activate interferons and myokines and hemokines. Hemokines. And start a fucked up reactor. All over again. The way people are getting it with this one, it seems like it really messes with the ACE2 binder. Causes super, I forget what, it's an LH. There's two things that are released from the binder site being used by us in the epithelial that causes a fucked up fucking storm. Or I should say cascading effect. It alludes to those lumps and shit like what my mom got in her body. Some dummies using the damn steroids. An after effect for years. I mean, if they don't understand, that's what most of what's happening with the people with the long COVID issues that they're talking about. The immunosuppression that they're doing. The hemokine, D-dimer, and myokines left over. And the leukocytes that are in muscle tissue and organ tissue that shouldn't be there. They end up just being the irritant. And fucking the body responds in a messed up way, like a blister. To kill our species off and everything else on the earth. We go DP882 on the macro level, start investing in trillions of dollars that you gotta buy bullets for UBC light and fucking everything and all that shit. Aerosols, ionic silvers, so forth, cleanse, use CRISPR. VP882 just slightly. Excuse me.
robots.
I want a robot.
War robots.
War robots.
Throw my dogs.
Throw my dogs.
Backing them.
Backing them.
Backing them up.
Backing them up.
This is such a horrible
spot. Yeah, yeah, so it is.
GoPro right here.
Speaking to the mic.
Speaking to the mic.
I'm gonna walk around
the flea market like this. There wouldn't be no unlimited, you know. People can't send on books. It's so tired of just people making up make believe.
Choreographed
shit.
It's all about
real life.
Don't mind
that we've been like, that's alright. This is my little, this is my kid's toy. Never seen it before. It's like a little mini thing.
The troll. New version is troll.
This
whole
box.
Fuck.
And you can read your pocket.
It's the big brother.
It's the big brother overseer fucking boy.
How you doing?
We don't want our best back home.
I'm not
This is what you need.
This is what you need when you go to the city, dude. Some shit won't bother you so much.
Oh, yeah. Okay.